When the real API is not yet finished, you don't have to wait for the backend devs. Just make sure to agree on a structure with your team and fake it using JSON Server. Let me show you how. Let's create a new quick project with npm. So open terminal and type npm init-y to proceed with the defaults. Let's go to JSON Server documentation page under GitHub, copy the npm install command and paste that into the terminal to install JSON Server globally. Let's go to the root directory and create a new file. You can name it whatever you want, but I will call mine api.json. This is where we will input our fake data, but always define the structure of the data with your team to avoid having to change things afterwards. My fake data will be about animals. Each key will have its own root where the array will be the output. So in this case, I would have a slash animals root to get all the animals. Let's go to their documentation to get the command to run JSON Server. Paste it in the terminal and I will change the name to api.json. If you now head to your browser and access the fake API at localhost:3000, you should see this main screen. And if you add slash animals or whatever you named your key, you should get a list of the fake data. Something cool here is that you can just add the ID of the animal to the URL to hit the read route and get all the information about that animal with that ID. This should be enough for most use cases, but there are so much more things you can do with this awesome tool. For example, a filter. If I add the type of dogs to the query, I will just get dogs, and it's the same for cats. If you're working on an infinite loader or some kind of pagination, this would be useful. You can add a page parameter to the URL and you can even set the items per page by passing in the limit. Sorting is also possible by passing in the sort parameter and giving the field name. To order the data by ascending or descending order, then we can use the order parameter. Something different than features about JSON Server is the config file. Let's create one right now. I'll create a file called json-server.json in the project root directory. Here we can set a different port for the API to run on, and something which I think is super amazing is the delay. We can set a number of milliseconds so that the API feels real, and maybe we want to show or test a loading system in our application. Also, just so that I don't have to add the watch option in the run command, I'll add that in the config. And now to run the JSON server, we will need to tell it to use the config file which we just created. There's so much more to learn about JSON Server, so make sure to check out their documentation where they explain more complicated stuff, such as relationships and operators such as greater than and less than to filter your data. You can even search through your data, maybe you want to work on a search feature for your app, and you can slice your data and so much more. Something super cool is that you can generate random data using JavaScript, and you can even use a library like Faker to generate a huge amount of realistic but fake data so you can have a huge dataset to work with. Thank you for watching and I hope you found this video interesting. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed this kind of educational content and I would also appreciate your feedback. See you in the next one.